In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of longus coli. Longus coli. This is very deep muscle. And interestingly, this muscle is in front of cervical spines and thoracic spines. I am going to explain its origin, insertion, function, and important anatomical relationship. Okay, you can divide longus coli for three parts. First part is vertical part. Vertical part, which is about this area. Next one is superior oblique part. Superior oblique. Next part is inferior oblique. Inferior oblique. Superior oblique part is about this part. Inferior oblique is about this part. So let me explain its origin and insertion. Origin of vertical part is about C5 through T3. So let's say this is T3, 2, 1, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and you don't see C1 because there is mandible, okay? It is about this area, right? This area is origin, C5 through T3. Insertion is C2 through C4. C2 through C4. Okay, by the way, this number is different, depends on anatomy book, because back muscles have many fibers, right? Like multifidus and erector spinae. So does longus coli. Its fiber is very multiple, right? That is why origin and insertion can be different, depends on anatomy book. Maybe this number is one below or one above. Okay. Now, let me explain superior oblique part. Origin of superior oblique part is C3 through 5. C3 through 5. This is origin. Insertion is C1. So about here. By the way, you don't see C1 because there is mandible. Origin and insertion of superior oblique part is C3 through C5 and C1. Let's move on to inferior oblique part. That is this one. Origin is T1 through T3. T1 through 3. So I change color T1 through T3 about here. This is origin. Insertion is C5 through C6. So about this area. C5 through C6. C5 through C6. So origin and insertion of vertical part is about here. Superior oblique part is about here. Inferior oblique part is about this area. I personally think that you don't have to remember every single number. Important thing is longus coli is in front of cervical spines and thoracic spines. Now, let me explain function of longus coli. There are longus coli on this side, of course. What happens when both sides contract? That brings neck to flexion. Neck flexion. This is very rare muscle. There are not many muscles which do neck flexion. There are several, like sternocleid mastoid, which is in front of neck. But again, important thing about longus coli is this muscle attaches in front of cervical spines. Very rare muscle. And this one does neck flexion. This is when both sides contract. What happens when one side contracts? That brings neck to side bend. Side bend is this movement. And one more movement, which is rotation. But which way of rotation is that? If you have seen my other videos, I introduce two kinds of rotation, right? Is it same side rotation or other side rotation? This is same side rotation. What is it? It's ipsilateral rotation. Ipsilateral rotation. Ipsilateral means same side. This is left side longus coli that brings neck to left rotation. This is ipsilateral. The other side means contralateral. Just for your information. When both sides contract, that does flexion. When one side contracts, that does side bend and ipsilateral rotation. Now, let me explain very important anatomical relationship with internal organs. This is side view. This is longus coli. This is in front of vertebra, right? And what are there? What are there in front of cervical spines? This yellow one. This is esophagus. Esophagus. This is right in front of cervical spines. That means you can say esophagus is right in front of longus coli. So there is relationship. What happens when longus coli gets tight? This can be from whiplash. This can be from head trauma, neck trauma, car accident. Many things can tighten up longus coli. Now, what happens to esophagus? Esophagus might be affected because of tightness of longus coli. Or, what happens when you have disease around esophagus? Maybe you have a gastroesophageal reflex. That can affect longus coli. Then that can affect cervical spines, don't you think? Because longus coli is just in front of cervical spines. So this is relationship between longus coli and esophagus. It's easy, right? And what is there in front of esophagus? It bifurcates inside of rib cage. What is it? This is trachea. Trachea is in front of esophagus. So, trachea does not attach to longus coli because there is esophagus. However, there is connection via myofascia because this area is very compact, very busy, very small area. That is why these are connected by membrane. So, if you follow this membranous connection, you can follow from longus coli to esophagus, esophagus to trachea. Now, if you have a breathing disease, that might affect esophagus. Now, that can affect longus coli. This is very busy area, very small area. So each dysfunction can affect everything. And one more thing, there is thyroid in front of trachea. See, this is very busy area. Tightness of longus coli can affect in front of neck restriction. Plus, I want to say one more thing. Remember, origin of longus coli is thoracic spines, T1 through T3, right? T3, that's inside of rib cage, isn't it? So this part can have connection with inside part of thorax. What's there? There is lungs. Yay! Lung is breathing organ, right? So tightness of longus coli might affect for lung. Okay, this is very important muscle in terms of internal organ connection. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of longus coli. I explained its origin, insertion, function, and relationship with internal organs. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.